Guys wondered how to put on our registration numbers. It's quite simple. Generally they're pre-masked. That is if you're putting it on a straight line. But I'm gonna take on this curvature here. So I'm gonna do them independently, one at a time. I use two pieces of wax paper. I mark the back side with a piece of tape or belt marker or whatever, just so I don't make a mistake. But what I do is, first thing I did was I measured how much space I would need. And I know I've got 9 numbers here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, that's pretty long. That one last number makes it pretty long. There's a short hole like this. Get myself a tape line to follow the radius. I know that I'm going to have to be really tight when I put these down. So here we go. By using the waxed side, I'm going to start with my number one here. I try not to touch the decals at all. And I'm going to line this up. Actually, I'm starting at the edge here, so I'll go on this side here. Basically, what I'm doing is I'm leaving a little bit of the decal exposed at the bottom. I just line it up on my wax paper, and I start right here. Number one's gonna go there. I tack down the bottom, I lift my wax paper, and I put it on gently, make sure I get all the air out. That's the first number. Consecutively, it's done the same way for each. Peel number three up. I'm gonna line that up on my wax paper again, like this, leaving the bottom part exposed. And then I can handle it like this. And I'm gonna look at my radius. Make sure everything lines up. My spacing has to be really tight for this one. So, attack the bottom. Notice what I'm doing here is I'm holding it up. Use my finger, just gently. If you have a mistake, you can lift this up and replace it. Just try not to stretch it. Because once this sets for a while, it's gonna be in place for good. There's the three. K's are kind of tricky, they're big. They got a fork in them at the top and the bottom. Try not to handle. The sticky part of the decal is gonna last a lot longer. Again, I'm gonna line it up on my wax paper. Put it down evenly here. And line it. Get the spacing. I don't have to come in any further than here. Of course, I did clean the hole first. That's gonna go with the tape a little bit, so I'm gonna peel back my tape here. Tack the bottom, start rolling the wax paper up, apply a slight bit of pressure with your finger, working the air out. Perfect. Next one, another one. Always use your wax paper if you can. They're tricky. The reason why I say the O's are tricky is because they're softer on the edge. So again, get it lined up on my wax paper. And then we'll put it in place. Tape under it, get it out of the way, tack the bottom, and it's tricky because there's two sides here, so we'll handle it very gently, and it'll work well. Sometimes you get a ripple like that. What you want to do is gently work the bigger part of the ripple out towards the edge, then use your wax paper and scrub it. After you've got them all down, you can generally take the back of the wax paper, place it over top, and scrub at the back of your fingernail. This way you're not damaging the surface of the clear lens laminate. It'll just look nicer, longer. And that's basically the same routine over and over again.